Welcome back for this week's edition of the 2023 March Madness Preview Show.
I'm Jeremy Bronstein, and we're nearly 1 week away from Selection Sunday. Let's get into the action from this week's games.
In the Big 12 on Wednesday, we saw TCU defend home court against Texas, winning 75-73. Led by Damian Baugh's 24 points and a double-double from Emmanuel Miller, the Big Night was capped off with a court storm by the TCU students. This game is just another in the latest edition of the Texas Longhorns' late-season slide. They've now dropped their last two games. They now have to face a rolling Kansas squad at home this Saturday and one of the biggest tests of the season, with Selection Sunday right around the corner.
Now, let's get into the conference that is just an absolute mess right now, the Big Ten. I unfortunately only watched the Big Ten last night, and I have to be honest, I kind of regretted it. Michigan and Illinois went down to the wire last night, with the Illini coming out on top in double overtime. Michigan's Joey Baker airballed a wide-open three to tie the game, and that would have been a huge win for the Wolverines, who are currently on the bubble. Another team on the bubble that needs a late rally is the Wisconsin Badgers. They had a close one last night against Purdue, but lost by two, 63-61. And finally, Rutgers just had a brutal loss to the worst team in the conference, Minnesota, on a buzzer beater. Rutgers will need a great Big Ten tournament to still have a shot at making the big dance. Right now, Joe Lunardi has 10 Big Ten teams to make the tournament. This conference is the definition of mid, but it will be interesting to see how many teams will make it come Selection Sunday.
Down in the SEC, Vanderbilt got a huge away win against Kentucky, 68-66, picking up their fourth Quadrant 1 win on the season. With this loss, Kentucky may slip out of the top 25, while Vanderbilt is now trending in the right direction with an upcoming home date against Mississippi State this Saturday. Alabama has this conference locked up for the regular season, but come tournament time, one of Tennessee or Texas A&M could make a run if they get hot at the right time.
Now it's over to Jordan to preview this week's games and next week's games.
Welcome back in, everyone. I did not have the same torture last night as Jeremy watching every single Big Ten game. As you guys remember, I'm more of a Nebraska ball fan. But I don't want to say I went 2-3 last week on picks, but I did go 2-3. Purdue, you stink. Looking into this weekend's games, I'm looking at Saturday. Sunday's the last day for any team's regular season games. But tomorrow, big one, Pac-12, number 8 Arizona at number 4 UCLA. And this game has huge NCAA tournament seeding implications. UCLA could make a huge statement win and set themselves up for a one seed bearing a Pac-12 tournament collapse. I know UCal's pretty dangerous. Arizona's hovering around the 2-3 seed range, but a win here and a dominant performance in the Pac-12 tournament could certainly set them up to be in striking distance of a one seed. This is the perfect regular season finale and should at the very least be an incredibly entertaining game. I think Arizona takes this game, but barely, 81-78 statement win. Moving over to the Big 12, we got another big time top 10 showdown. Number 3 Kansas ends their season at number 9 Texas. I talked about Texas last week, and just about everything went wrong for them. Two losses, they're now trying to avoid a disastrous 3-game losing streak to end their season. A loss here for the Longhorns would require them to have a big, big 12 tournament run to have a shot at a 2-seed in the NCAA tournament, as other teams would most certainly jump them. A win for Kansas here gives them a great shot for a 1-seed placement. Prepare for a big-time showdown in Austin, in what is sure to be one of the hardest fought games of the year. I think Texas follows the Big 12 season script, gets a big home win, putting them back on track. Give me Texas 79, Kansas 73. We're going to go on hiatus for 3 weeks, but join us then as we review the first round of the NCAA tournament.